Well, hi everyone. We're going to continue our discussion on the Scorpion Mod M from Tokyo Marui. There's a number of things I didn't get a chance to talk about when I was doing the unboxing. Of course, I wanted the unboxing to be separate from the discussion with the gun itself. So what I want to talk about on this next segment has to do with the battery power. How do we improve that? Because the AEPs are notorious for having difficult batteries. There's solutions for those. Also, I want to talk about the meters per second, the joule count, the stopping power of the Mod M. You know, do you get any hits with it at distance? Also, the durability, the feel of the gun itself, the overall length. You know, numerous things we're going to be discussing with the Scorpion Mod M. I have a chance now to use it in one of our events. I'm impressed with the gun, and I noticed that Tokyo Marui has had this bit going on in the websites calling it an AEG, and I always assumed it was an AEP. So perhaps we can talk a bit about the characteristics of what makes an AEP as opposed to what makes an AEG. Is the Scorpion Mod M an AEG or an AEP? So automatic electric gun or an automatic electric pistol? So we can have a little bit of discussion about that. Okay, so let's get right to it, guys. Okay, let's get right into this, shall we? So let's first address probably the most difficult issue everyone has with the AEPs, and that has to be the battery. Traditionally, this is the battery people would use, the 7.2 volt, 550 milliamp battery. It never really seemed to have enough power. When you charged it, it always seemed like you could actually feel it draining, even on an hour event. Now, I use the Scorpions mostly in Airsoft Plus events, so there I fired on three-round bursts. And I find when I fire on three-round bursts, I tend to have quite a good amount of battery power. Even with these simple batteries like this, I don't seem to have too much difficulty. However, it is annoying, and I can tell right away when I'm changing the battery, because I'm so annoyed the fact that it's draining. I'll put one of these, a fresh one in, and then just go and recharge the other one. Where we're inside, of course, that doesn't make much of a difference. We have outlet sockets, power, and everything. When you're outside, though, this is what really is the problem. You have a whole bunch of these, and you're just changing them all the time. And if it's cold, well, basically you can't use your AEP outside. It's just a notorious pain in the ass. I don't play outside anymore, and I don't care. Anyway, so now there has been this Dragon Pro. It's still 550 milliamps, and this one is 7.2 volts. And what's nice is that when you order the Scorpion Mod M from Tokyo Marui, you will get this adapter. And these are really simple to use, all right? So you just simply take the adapter, you take the battery itself, and it slides right into the slot like that. You tuck in the connector, the recharging connector, and now it's simply inside. And this fits directly into the Mod M. Now, what's nice about the Mod M is the pistol grip itself has been modified. This is not how the original Scorpion pistol grip looks. If you look here at the original, it's somewhat bent and so forth. So, you know, there's not a lot of room there to play around with trying to get extra power in. And as you can see here with the Mod M, it's straight and there's plenty of room here. And just like the original one, off comes this cap. This is always a little bit tricky. Then you make sure this goes in the right way. It's in the right way, pops right in. On goes the cap, done. Now, this should fire very, very nicely. Semi-automatic, and now full automatic. It sounds like I have plenty of power. And it sounds like I'm going to have plenty of power for my entire event. And where I'm firing on three-round bursts, the gun actually sounds really great. it sounds like I don't have any worries about power at all for my event. So that's the one big plus with this Mod M, is that we're dealing with now these Dragon Pro 550 milliamp batteries as opposed to these ones. I'm hoping I never have to see these again. And
I hit you with no rounds. I'm out of rounds.
I shot him in the leg and he bounced his Chico.
Okay.
Bounced a single shot.
I got a young man. Go ahead, defend. I'm gonna grab some magazines, guys. You're on your own. I also changed my battery.
Hoping that I'm only going to be using these. And just to let you know as well that I'll put a link in the description, and then you'll be able to have plenty of power as well by ordering these. They came in a couple of days from Europe. Pretty easy to deal with. Okay, great. Thanks, guys. Okay, just out of curiosity, let's see if that Dragon Pro battery works in the original Scorpio. So let me just haul this out. Here's the original Scorpion. Seem to have a really good fit. And do we get the same battery power? Yes, we do. So this Scorpion now, this original Scorpion now has a great deal more power. And I have to say that if you are a big fan of the AEPs, the original AEPs, and you buy those Dragon Pro batteries, get an adapter, now you're dealing with plenty of power. There should no longer be this issue of, oh my goodness, I have enough power, it's running out, it really sucks. So you don't have to deal with that issue anymore. Just get one of those Dragon Pro LiPo batteries, and then you have no difficulty whatsoever in keeping your gun charged for whatever event you're doing.
Okay, let's have a look at the overall length then of the Scorpion M, Scorpion Mod M, how it compares to the other AEPs. So if I just simply just take a measuring tape and just go along the length with it open, we get about, let's see, 56.5 centimeters. With the stock extended. So let's then get another AEP in here and we look at it. The MP7 looks like it's just a touch bit longer. It's almost exactly at 60. So we have a few extra centimeters. And let's look then at the original Scorpion with the butt extended. Do we get exactly the same length? And without the barrel extension to hold on to the suppressor, we're looking there at about 48 centimeters. So, you know, the Scorpion Mod M falls in between then the MP7 and the original Scorpion. So there you can say then that are we dealing with an AEG or an AEP? When I look at the Scorpion Mod M, I see the part they put on the front here. It looks very similar to another gun that I have, and that happens to be the MP7. If you look at them together, you can see that, well,
it looks like what they did, they simply took their production line and modified it somewhat to then have an MP, instead of pumping out MP7s front ends, they started pumping out Scorpion Mod M's. So it looks almost identical in the front. So the understanding where the rails go, the gaps and so forth they've put in for ventilation, it looks very comparable. I have to say that when I'm putting the two of them together, they look, well, one could almost say identical. And, you know, I have to say that's very clever of Tokumarui. They know they have a real winner with this Scorpion Mod M, certainly by the looks. And making it similar to the AEPs will get those people, who are very interested in using AEPs and the education about how to use them, especially with the LiPo batteries. That's why they give them the adapter. So they really are looking then for a particular market of people who like to use these AEPs. To me, Tokumarui is right on the money. They can simply take their old model Scorpion like that, add a little bit of flavor from the very popular MP7, and voila, now we have the Scorpion Mod M. I have to say, pretty clever of Tokumarui, and I have to say my hat's off to them. I mean, I'm impressed with the gun, and I do like the AEPs, so I have to say that that's a pretty good combination for me. That's probably the reason why I really like it, since I like both the original Scorpion, and I certainly do like the MP7, so kudos to them. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about how to aim this thing. So, you know, on the original Scorpion, they have these iron sights here, back sight, fore sight. And then, of course, I always find that the Scorpion itself is really short, and that's why I've added on this suppressor. The suppressor, when I'm holding it, you know, like this, it allows me to aim, and I'm always holding the Scorpion, the original Scorpion, like so, and that way I'm able to aim it. I'm able to see my targets much better. You know, when I'm looking at these sights, we don't have much of a sight. However, this is something they have affixed to the gun itself. We're looking at the MP7, the original sights here. If we just ignore the red dot a bit, you can see we have some sighting system, you know, so they're trying to make it look, you know, one-to-one from the original. And then they put this nice big rail on the top here, and then guys like my son have added this really nice red dot, and of course he's added a laser dot sight as well, so he's able to hone in on his targets. And you know, using the original sights are just fine. That's certainly how I use my MP7. I don't use the red dot or laser sighting at all. And when we're coming now then to the Scorpion Mod M, wait a second, where are the sights? You know, where this is a modification, it's not being modified for anything in reality. It's simply just being modified to look damn cool. So that means these rails and so forth on here are for you to add sights yourself. That way, you can enjoy the Mod M whatever way you like. They have put, and I'm gonna move my camera up a little bit. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. I'm gonna see. If you can't see it like that, then I will move the camera around. They do have a little spot here where you can sight down, and it's even in the illustrations in the box. You can see there is a sight picture right along the whole rail here to this little tiny post, front post. And of course, you would think, well, my God, how on earth can one aim using that? And I have to say that that's one hardship that I like about using the Scorpion Mod M, that I'm not going to put red dots or anything like that, any kind of sight assistance on the rails at all. And I notice when I've started playing with it that I don't need to have this extension, this suppressor, So I'm able to sight down the gun using my hand. I'm able to use my sight picture like that. So I don't need this at all, because the overall length of the Scorpion itself allows me to be able to see my targets. And we're firing CQC. I don't have to have, I don't need to have precision targets. I can simply be very precise firing over the gun itself by looking at my target and putting the rounds right on my target. I have to say that that's the hardship that I want to use with my Scorpion Mod M. I want to be able to fire this without having any assistance at all from any devices, simply using the iron sights and my experience to know where the rounds are going to land. That, for myself, is what I'm going to be emphasizing when I'm using this.
Oh! Good range! Wow, okay, the Scorpion has some nice power.
I have seen photographs and so forth on the internet of quite ridiculous sighting gadgets or toys on top of these things, and, you know, just have to laugh at them. You know, I understand that these reels here for those guys who like that bling idea. Certainly that's not what I'm going to be doing. So the aiming for this takes skill when there isn't any kind of an assistance on top. And you see from my video that I'm not having any difficulty at all sighting this, getting my sight picture and able to hit my targets, quite small targets at quite the distance. So that is going to be the hardship for me, is going without having any kind of assistance with regard to the sight picture.
Hi guys, just finished a 3-hour event, the Airsoft Plus event we have here Tuesday nights from 6 to 9. And I was firing the Scorpion on 3-round burst the entire evening. And I had that Dragon Pro LiPo into the pistol grip here to make the thing work. And I have to say that if you listen to it now, it still sounds very, very crisp, even on semi-automatic. That with those mini-type batteries, the trigger wouldn't feel as crisp. It wouldn't feel I had any control at all. Or at least it would be really sluggish. And I would feel that the gun itself has control and not me. Hi everyone again. So I put the chrono up to the muzzle of the Mod M, Scorpion Mod M, and it chronoed consistently at 0.78 to 0.79 meters per second, well under 1 joule. And I'm really surprised it chronoed that high. When I chrono the old, the non-Mod M Scorpion, it fired exactly at 0.68 to 0.69. So with the Mod M, we're getting 0.1 meter per second more, which is quite significant. So to me, it looks like they have not only modified the outside, they have also modified the inside. Now, this Scorpion here, you might say, hey, Philip, it's a little bit older. Yeah, that's true. However, the internals haven't degraded at all. So I have to say that it's simply that the modifications they've done with the Mod M for the outside, or the Scorpion for the outside, they have now done, of course, for the inside. Okay, now
With that, let's have a slight discussion, shall we, about this automatic electric pistol, AEP, and automatic electric gun, AEG. So, is the Scorpion Mod M an AEP or an AEG? Well, I'm going to say it's both. I don't mean to sit on the fence on this. However, when I look at the original Scorpion, it's a one-to-one ratio with regard to the real ones. So, you know, they did a nice job in taking the Scorpion itself to make it look that you can see the Scorpion in it. It's very clear this is a Scorpion with modifications. And the modifications make it look like we have an MP7. And this MP7 from Aruri, of course, as well, from the front end, we can see that we have an AEP. And again, that if I put the rails here on the vents, then I'm going to look essentially like I have an MP7. So from outward appearances, externally, we have an AEP. And as I mentioned previously, that this has been a really good coup for Tokyo Marui to appeal to those players who like using AEPs by giving them an AEP that looks exactly like the Scorpion with some MP7 parts. So those guys like me go, wow, okay, this is cool, really nice, I want it. And then they probably have listened to the fact that this one is shooting 0.68, 0.69 meters per second. And now, hey, let's appeal to those guys who would like to have the AEG. And so let's increase by 0.1 meter per second. And I think that that, again, is another brilliant move by Tokyo Marui. They have taken just, maybe they have a bunch of these in stock, who knows? They said, how can we get people to start buying more of these? And they said, why don't we just modify one of the originals, make it look like an AEP, but actually it's an AEG. So this satisfies those players who want to have more power. And this one, certainly that 0.1 meter per second difference is significant, especially when you play in a CQC site, like here at the back alley. I could see immediately the differences from using the ordinary Scorpion, the original one, and then using the modified version. So it looks like an AEP, fires like an AEG. And I have to say that for people like myself, this is a great gun for me. I'm able to airsoft the way I wish, have the power when I need it. And there are moments when I feel that I really need to have a lot of power to stop players that are further away. And certainly this is the one. And when I talk about stopping players, when I'm using the Scorpion AEP, the original version, I often have to make excuses for the players, because where it doesn't have that much power, the players don't feel the rounds. They don't count the hits. It's nothing against them. I'm not saying that they're cheating. It's just that they can't feel the hits. They're wearing gear, all kinds of things, and there's a certain percentage that the hits aren't counted. And that's what you have to accept when you're firing an AEP. Guys just don't feel the rounds. When you're playing CQC style, like we do here at the back alley, there are moments when you get so excited, you just can't feel the rounds. You're running and things are happening and you can't feel the rounds. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's just part of the game. And since we don't play competitive airsoft, even in the Airsoft Plus events, these issues are no big deal for us. So what? Just a game, we're having good fun. So when I then use the modified
scorpion, that the hit issue, it's not considered at all. When I've been using this now a couple of events, I don't think I had anyone have an issue when the rounds were on target, they counted them. And I have to say that that's for those people who have been really turned off by the AAPs because they're too lightweight, they don't have a lot of stopping power, whatever. So the modifications they've done to the Scorpion Mod M will certainly satisfy that for those players who want to have an AEG. This is certainly a great alternative. So if you want to have a great gun that looks like an AAP, and you can coolify it, because, you know, the original Scorpion, you can't coolify it. You can coolify this one. It's already cool the way it is. So you can go and have your bling. And I think there's a large percentage of players who don't come airsofting for the sport. They come airsofting just for the bling, for the fun of having a great gun. So, you know, so now you have, I don't know if the word in 21st century you can say anymore is just, it's not sexy. It looks a little bit dull. It's representative of what the real one looks like. However, so what? This is airsoft. These aren't real guns. So now we have something that looks a little bit more cool. Sexified, coolified, blingified, whatever you want to call it. If you think sexified is sexist, then use other words, superlatives. And so then we're thinking, okay, now we can bling it up. Now we can bling up the gun. And now we have stopping power. I think the last thing I want to say is that there's a player we have who comes here to the back alley. He's quite a tall man. Much taller than me. I have to say that I come to his shoulders. And when he put the Mod M in his hands, it was a pistol. It looked funny because he said, are you going to use that like an AEG? I said, yeah. He says, well, to me it's a pistol. So I guess it depends on your perspective. That are you dealing with an AEP or are you dealing with an AEG? It's entirely up to how you want to characterize it. For me, I think it's both. So, great gun. Certainly, it fits a number of niches when you're dealing with CQC setting. So, thanks, guys. Hope to see you in the game soon. Thank you. Yeah, bye-bye.
in my world.
Oh, ouch! I don't know. Where's the ammo can, guys? Okay, yep. Yep. It's green in front. Okay, here we go, guys. Good job, 15. Still our bomb, guys. Bye.